Hi everyone, I'm JD Hoovener, your host of the Bold Today Show, where you, the inventor, entrepreneur, or business owner, get your daily dose of inspiration to make the world a better place. All right, you made it. Hope you had a great weekend. Happy Monday. Let's get down to business, everybody. This week is going to be about how you and your startup are going to be able to take patents to the next level. To start, this week we're doing a five-part series digging into the Bold Ideas book. And we're going to start about what we're going to learn, what every startup needs to know about trade secrets and innovation, including patent law, as they move through each step of the process. Let's start with chapter 19. In chapter 19, we're going to cover non-disclosure agreements and the major issues around disclosure, which does tend to happen in the startup world. We hear a lot, and I do when I do consultations, from clients that say, oh, you know, we launched a Kickstarter campaign months ago, and we've been selling a bunch of these, or we've been getting a lot of investor money. We've taken this to a trade show. We've sold a few units. And my first gut reaction is I cringe, because the rules for disclosure are that if you have sold, offered for sale, or publicly disclosed your invention more than a year ago, it is no longer eligible for patenting. And so I always hope that those public disclosures and sales are within a year. Otherwise, we're in a world of hurt and we can't actually protect it under patent law. So one of the first things to know about disclosure is that it is allowed when it's under a confidentiality agreement. And a NDA is the common acronym for a non-disclosure agreement, is the contract that's used. If you don't have the means, or the funds, or the ability to file a patent application first, a non-disclosure agreement is the second best option. And that's what Chapter 19 of the Bold Ideas book goes through. So get your copy. It's an electronic version on our website. You can pick that up at boldpatents.com and get your copy today. We have an electronic PDF version, and if you'd like to have a hard copy, we'll send one out to you. So Chapter 19 details much more about what an NDA entails, when to get it signed, and all about the state-specific issues that can come up, making sure that each party that signs it, it'll be binding on them. So back to disclosure. In the US, of course, there is this one-year grace period. There are countries in Europe that actually are absolute novelty countries, meaning if you've disclosed it or sold that your invention before filing, you have zero rights, zip. That's why we always urge our inventors to file first. It's not only a way to avoid, you know, an issue where you're not going to have any rights due to early disclosure, but it's a wonderful way to be able to beat any other inventors that are out there in the world. As I've talked in previous shows, we discuss how the law, the patent law, has changed into what was a first-to-invent country into a first-to-file system with the American Invents Act passage in 2013. With this change, two inventors that have the same invention, you know, in two different parts of the country, and they both independently invent it, it's not who invented it first who gets the patent, it's who files it first. So even more reason to get with a patent attorney to get your invention filed. So if you have any questions about the patent process, non-disclosure agreements, technology, and getting your startup going, the very first phase, do not launch your Kickstarter. Get with us, get with one of our patent attorneys first to make sure we can assess the situation, make sure we protect you before you go give it away to the public. I'm your host, JD Hoovener of the Bold Today Show. It's been a pleasure talking with you. Have a good day. Go big, go bold.